It has been 8 years since the South African men's national under-20 football team managed to qualify for the World Cup. But coach Thabo Senong is determined to end that poor run as he completes his second two-year cycle with the team. The upcoming under-20 Africa Cup of Nations in Zambia also serves as a World Cup qualifier.
Well, as mentioned earlier on, we spoke to the national team coach of the men's under-20 team, Amajita. The team is preparing for their AFCON that will be taking place later on this month in Zambia. The coach spoke well of the preparations, spoke positively and saying that the team and the players are responding well to the preparations ahead of that tournament. The team is leaving on Friday to Zambia as part of their preparations. They'll be coming back home to Polokwane to complete their preparations.
The preparations have been going very well. The players have reported in camp last night. We're starting our first training session today, and we're looking forward to the final phase of preparation. We are going to a very, very tough tournament, and then we've lined up some good friendlies against Zambia, the host, and then of course against Mali, a West African country that always excels in this kind of tournaments. Of course, it's always a challenge for us as a technical team to identify the best 21 that will represent the country, because we have a lot of talent, but we are obviously looking for a balanced squad, because we are going to face a different opposition. We need to have a team that has aerial strength, so that we can compete with those West African teams aerially, physically, but also we're looking for a team that can help us keep our identity, you know, mobility, quick passing game, combination play, pace, skill, penetration, 1-2s. So yeah, we've brought in a balanced team that we believe that it can give us a balance. But yeah, of course, it's always tough to identify the best players. We're working with youngsters. Sometimes they lose form, but yeah, let's see how they respond in this final camp. And after a week, we'd surely know that this is our best 21 that will take us forward.
The coach is satisfied with the composition of the team, and what makes him happier is that the players are getting regular game time, looking that most of the players in the team are locally based and playing regularly in the MDC. He's only got three players that are playing abroad.
With the physical demands that we are going to face in the tournament, it is very, very important to select players that are match fit, players that are getting playing minutes every weekend, and we must say a big thank you to leagues like the multi-choice disc league, where we see a lot of youngsters getting playing minutes. Of course, our ABC Motsepe League, SAFA second division league, we have also some players that are getting good playing minutes, and the SAB league as well. And then that is where we source most of these players, you know. And we believe that with players that are match fit, with players that are fit mentally, then we shouldn't have a problem in terms of building a solid squad.
2016 was a busy year for the team. They played the qualifying rounds for the AFCON that's taking place this month. They concluded the year by playing in the COSAFA, reaching the final and losing by a slim margin to Zambia, who are the hosts of this particular tournament. However, the coach says that tournament was good preparation for the team ahead of the tournament, and he says that he's satisfied in how the team played, and he's looking at the mistakes that the team made during the tournament to rectify so that they don't repeat the same errors that they did in December.
The COSAFA tournament was the best preparation for the CAF under 20 AFCON. And we had a very fruitful tournament. We played good football. We had a clear identity on how we play as a team. We could see that this team represents South African football, and it represents modern football. And we scored a lot of goals. There are games where we won 8-0, 5-0. There are games where we won 1-0, you know. So it was a fruitful tournament. And then, of course, we lost in the final hurdle. We're working with youngsters. They can be inconsistent at times. They can experience lapse of concentration. And that is what we have learned in the tournament, you know, how to deal with critical phases, you know, first 15 minutes of the match, and then the last final 10 minutes of the game, where players need to concentrate in the game and just make sure that they don't lose focus, they continue making the right decisions in terms of the choices of the passes, the decisions of the tactical movements, you know, that we have to make as an individual, as groups, and as teams. So yeah, we benefited a lot from the tournament. We had a good run, of course, and we believe that it was the best preparation for the AFCON going forward.
The Under-20 AFCON tournament also serves as a World Cup qualifier. Now, in 2015 in Senegal, the South African team failed to qualify for the World Cup of that year. They came fifth, and Thabo Senong was the head coach at that time as well. He goes in for the second time to Zambia, and he says that experience will help him qualify the team for the World Cup in Korea in May.
Yeah, obviously, of course, you know, the experience will always be handy. Was very fortunate, you know, to be the head coach in 2015, and then of course to also be the assistant coach in the Under-23 AFCON. You know, we believe that this kind of experiences will help us to deal with the tactical situations, the competitive phases of that tournament itself. And even you look at the technical team that we have assembled, you know, we still have our under-17 head coach, Mlefi Ntseki, so that he brings his experience as he last qualified the under-17 to the World Cup. And we've even brought in Helman Kelele also as one of our assistant coach. You know, he's one of the players that was part of the 1996 Bafana Bafana AFCON success, you know. So the technical team that we assembled has the right brains, has the right experience to make sure that we come up with a very good plan so that we go there, we perform very well, because this team belongs to the country, this team belongs to the association, and the country and SAFA will be very proud if we really qualify for the World Cup. And it is our ambition, it is my ambition as a coach, and then of course it is the ambition and the desire of the players. They want to see themselves playing against the best in the world, and this is the best platform, this is the best opportunity for them. Showcase their talent in the CAF tournament and eventually showcase their talent in a FIFA tournament in Korea in May.
Amachita are in Group B, and the coach doesn't believe that it is a group of death. However, looking at the composition of the group, it's Senegal, Sudan and Cameroon. And he says Sudan, having eliminated Nigeria, none of those teams can be taken for granted.
Look, starting with Sudan, I mean, they eliminated Nigeria to be part of this AFCON. So you can't really relax when you're playing against them. We have to work very hard, put a lot of effort in planning just to make sure that we're fully informed about their strengths, weaknesses, key players, possible formation, and the same with the West Africans. Cameroon, Senegal, you know, there are possible formations. Our boys need to be fully aware of that. Possible key players, you know, their style of play, you know, how they play. Do they play direct football? Do they play possession football? Do they build from the back? How they utilize their dead ball situations? So it's a very tough assignment as a technical team, and it's a very tough challenge for the boys. But we fully believe in the squad that we have. We have highly talented players. We have a good group. We have a good team, you know, in general. And yeah, we believe that if we use our skills properly, we have a chance of doing well in this tournament.